Alright, and we're back. So last episode, we fixed up some stuff with the cat, and we started unwrapping the UVs. I'm unwrapping the UVs this way instead of smoothing it and then unwrapping because I think it's better this way. It's less pieces to deal with. It's easy to keep track of, whatever. So we have this piece done. We're gonna go onto the legs, isolate, select those. I have the legs together as one object because I want to be able to sculpt both at the same time if need be. But in order to do that, I need to make sure that they're definitely on both sides. They're definitely as far away from the origin point as the other. So we're just gonna check that real quick. So we're gonna duplicate this. Minus the scale. Right? And then we definitely face transforms combine. Right? Same for the feet. Separate them. Duplicate. Minus one. Combine again. Freeze transforms. Right? In all of this, always remember, delete your history. And if you're doing any so say if I wanted to fix something on this that would require mirror geometry, I would have to re-UV it again because you're deleting geometry that's been UV'd and you're copying geometry that has also been UV'd, so it creates a bit of a mess and you just have to be cognizant of it. And let's rename this again, Chad Man Legs 01. Chad Man Feet 01. Right. Like I said, legs, bring it to isolate select. Some pretty legs. And we're going to do the same thing, auto unwrap. Right, so I want the seam to be, there's a problem. These poles. Remember what I said about the poles? They're good people, but you don't want them in your meshes. Alright, let's try that again. Let's unwrap. Alright, so we want to add a border on the inside of the leg. Come in right below here. That's one. That's two, and that's it. Piece of cake. Well, not yet. Let's check and make sure. Okay, let's go back. Remove these borders. Remove borders here. Alright, and then we're going to select half of this here, add borders here. I think that should make a more even, much better, much better. Alright, so we're done with that. Let's check this timer. And 19:47. 20. Right, wrong 8:20. Alright, palms, legs, feet. Oh, we need to bevel some edges here as well. One second. This is what I would be doing regardless. Like, if this mesh could only stay this way, I would still be doing it like this to bevel the edges. Just to get well, nice little round edge without really sacrificing much. Alright, that should be fine. Again, go into Auto and Rock UV. I'm gonna place this at the back of the shoe. And come all the way down to the middle there. Or rather, I'm going to come here. No. 1, 2, 5, 6. 1, 2. Just a second. Alright, sorry about that. Alright, so we're placing one here and we're gonna bring that to here. Alright, our borders, and that should be fine. We're good to go. We need some cute little boots. Alright. Last things, the mustache. Even though with this, I could probably just like unwrap the thing myself, but why? You know? Borders, good to go. Now you may be noticing that everything I'm putting it on seems to have a varying density of the checkup, and that's because all of them, when I'm UVing them, all of them are acting as if they all have one texture map to themselves, which isn't the case. We're going to change that. But afterwards. Alright, so let's get this one. Let's unwrap into two clothes. Actually, I'm just going to select this whole border here. Let's check what's going on. Now, how is that happening? Pretty sure I specified. Pretty sure I've specified everything. Okay, so let's go back. Alright, we added borders everywhere. Continue. Alright, there we go. Alright, we're done here. It's better to keep it like this. Hello. Purple is the best color. Thank you for agreeing. Alright. So we have finished unwrapping just about everything except for the hat. See, that's when you don't unwrap something. If you took that in the mud box and tried to paint on it, it would start screaming. You would start screaming, the program would start melting, your computer would start melting, the earth would spiral into the sun. So we don't want that. So we are going to select this here. Last piece. No, not this. Bonus tools on wrap. I'm going to select from this little point. How am I doing this? Okay, I'm going to start from the middle here. Come straight down to the back. Select here. Bring it on the front. Let's try that again. Select here. Right. Add borders. And let's see if that works. That worked perfectly. Oh man, that came out nice. Okay. We have unwrapped the charred man. So now what we're gonna do, open up the outliner here. And aside from deleting history, which we always do because if you don't delete history, you get weird little things like this. So, delete that. And it's still happening. Okay, we're just... let's stick it out. Alright, you get weird little groups like that. So we're gonna take all these and group them and call that Charman GRP01. Alright, I'm gonna open this up hand. I want to see that everything is on top of each other. Again, if we were to take this and turn it into Mudbox and start painting on the chest, it's going to start painting on everything else that this UV is covering. Maybe only the face would be spared. So we're going to select all these shells. And we're just going to go to unfold. See what that does. Oh wait, no, it doesn't take me on unless these are combined. Or does it? Should be able to lay out. Let's try layout. There we go. Alright, so you can use this. Like, say you have a small acid bundle that you're working on. Have a little plant, you have a little tree, just little things. You don't want to have to waste a 1024 by 1024 map on each one of them. You can take the different objects and place the UVs here, select layout. It's gonna separate them, on the correct ratios, and you can adjust it however you like after that. But what I like to do, even after this, is to space out, rotate and space out some of the stuff myself to get the maximum space. Because the more space you have, the less, the smaller your map can afford to be, because there's more space in the square itself. And bring this across. You want to be very careful that nothing is overlapping the other, or even like that. You want to make sure, like I would bring this across a little bit, because that's pretty close. Right, it doesn't really matter what direction it's facing, so long as it's fitting within the 0-1 space. And we have this, that. I'm gonna rotate these two. And I'm going to take all of these and scale them up together to get as much space within this that I can. Let's see if I can. So I'm going to bring this up here. Bring this. Bring this across here. See if I could just inch this just a little bit. Right. So I could bring them up more. I want them to fit as snug within this map that I possibly can. And then too, it's good to leave space in case like something extra is added on. Just in case, you know? Right, we can save that. And I think I can and safely smooth this now. Mesh smooth. All It's a little too smooth. No, it's not that bad. Why are we not showing the polygons? Polygons 7,000. 7,000 polygons. How big is the room? Let's check how big he is. Alright, the new combined is good gravy. He's about 12,000. Okay, well, 7,000 really isn't a problem. Alright, mesh smooth. Alright. So we got these nice little knee areas. We kept the shape, which I was saying, which is why I beveled all these edges, so that we would keep our shapes. You see, we didn't really keep the shape here. So let's bevel these edges too. Because I want to keep that edge. That didn't work at all. You're dead. Alright, let's do that again. Smooth. And dare I say it, we are ready to go. Save scene as Chadman underscore Will Polly. See, kept our shapes. Important. Alright, and let's just check back in. Alright, we got everything in order. And it is safe to take this into my box now. Alright, so we're gonna select the group. Export selection. CM underscore low poly base. Alright, the only problem on supported maps. FBX doesn't take the map that comes with the auto unwrap UV tool. Alright, so since we're going into sculpting next, I'm going to end the episode off here and then start sculpting in the next one. I'm going to take about 10 minute break maybe, just to walk around and whatnot. So I'll see you back in about 10 minutes and we're going to get started on sculpting.